Honorable Minister for Road Transport and Highways of India and Shipping, Ministry of Micro, Small and Medium Enterprises, Government of India, Shri Nitin Gadkari ji. Can we have a round of applause? Mr. Sandeep Aggarwal, founder Droom and Shop Clues.
No country has ever achieved economic freedom unless it has provided transportation freedom to its people.
Ladies and gentlemen, presenting our session, Future of Transport. Will the coming decade be a game changer? Please join me in welcoming our esteemed group of panelists. First and foremost, Mr. V.K. Saraswat, member Niti Aayog. Can we have a round of applause for Sir? Mr. Sandeep Aggarwal, founder Droom and Shop Clues. Mr. Ravi Talamaraju, Head Technical Services Global Petronas Lubricants International. And the session will be moderated by Mr. Parikshit Luthra, Assistant Editor, CNBC TV 18.
So we are now exempted electric car, taxi, electric bus, and even electric bike and biofuel bike, biofuel taxi, and biofuel bus, free from permit raj.
I'd like to get in Sandeep Aggarwal. And Sandeep, Mr. Gadkari, he's someone who is in the second-hand car online business. The market is changing very fast, Sandeep. In the next 10 years, we're looking at a slump right now, but a lot of people also say that subscription is going up, rentals are going up. What about the second-hand car market? And how do you see the future of transport over the next 10 years?
First of all, I would like to, it's a privilege to share stage with the Honorable Minister. I'm a big fan of your vision and leadership, and I've always been. And Mr. Manjal and Mindmine for having me here. In terms of future of transportation, you know, I would say, first of all, no country has ever achieved economic freedom unless it has provided transportation freedom to its people. In 1944, when US was struggling with World War II, General Eisenhower, which became the president eventually, built the best road transportation in geographically probably the third largest country on earth. And then next 90 years, US achieved massive economic growth. India is the third largest automobile market in the world, yet only 4% of Indian households have a car and 25% have a two-wheeler. We are 67th per capita vehicle availability. So I can't tell you how happy I was hearing that EV, hydrogen, all is good, but that's a choices people make. But one thing which is not a choice, which is a necessity, is the freedom of transportation. So I feel if this country can go from 4% penetration to 70% penetration, where I can now do commerce, I can do my job, I can go attend a wedding, not have to worry about things. That is, in my view, the future of transportation.
Just to ask you one more quick question before we return to all our panelists for more comments. What is going to drive demand? Indian customer is a cost-conscious customer.
Scrapping policy. He is the person related with it.
So this is important. And I'd like to ask you about the scrapping policy as well, because Mr. Gadkari's ministry right now is working on a scrapping policy. But the industry also, sir, is asking for an incentive-based scrapping policy. Sandeep, your views, and then maybe we can also...
This is what was done successfully in many parts of the world.
Yeah.
So look, the vehicle, a typical vehicle has 12 to 20 years economic life, and it will change ownership 3 to 5 times during that time. So if we can manage the entire life cycle, not just buying and selling and adoption, but also disposing, will obviously encourage. It's the asset, you know, our finance minister's statement was there about economic is all about churn. So this is a churn-based asset. So if we have a scraping and we manage the entire life cycle, obviously increase the, you know, it will create the room for the new innovation, but it will also manage the entire life cycle where someone has already spent money as a capital expenditure from his saving, has to still realize that. But on the other hand, new technology, we have to pave way for the new things to come also.
Mr. Gadkari, would you like to give clarity on scrapping, sir? How are we moving ahead? Right now, there is a draft notification.
Actually, we can reduce the production cost of the automobile vehicle by 15 to 20% by using this scrapping policy.
My question to Sandeep at this point. Sandeep, now when we're hearing about these different modes of transport in the future, where do you think the demand would be coming from the most? What is the consumer looking at different levels?
As Honorable Minister mentioned about various transportation, I was very impressed by the water connecting Gateway of India to the new airport. So I think the country is very futuristic in terms of developing the public transportation. But I think to answer your question, the demand is about is a last mile problem, right? As we develop more, and India is adding 7 million people in urban population every year, they still need from Huda, I run a company in Gurgaon. 400 people take an auto or something to come from Huda city center to the office, right? So I think the one problem is the last mile problem. Second is, yes, ride hailing is sharing some problem, solving some problem. But, I want to go to Vaishno Devi. I want to buy my TV. On Sunday, I want to take my entire family for a movie and shopping. That's not going to be solved by Ola and Uber. So my point is, demand is very simple, which has been there for last 90 years, and we should do everything to fuel it, right? And that is demand is really the last mile problem demand.
At a time of slowdown, it's very important to keep thinking for the good times ahead. Mr. Saratwat, Mr. Munjal, Mr. Gadkari, Ravi, Sandeep, thank you very much for joining us. And we'd like to especially thank Mr. Gadkari for taking out time, answering all these questions very, very patiently. Thank you very much.
Can we have a big round of applause for this fabulous session? Very insightful. A big thank you to Mr. Gadkari for giving us his precious time and blessing us with his presence. Thank you, sir. I would also request, sir, to kindly present a memento to our esteemed group of panelists.